Looks like it's on, but now it is.
Thank you. Clear prop. Right, brakes. Clear left brakes, clear the pulley. Give me those red ones. Thank you. Okay. Roll on throttle. All right.
Nice takeoff.
Thank you, sir. Sunrise again this morning. Today we're flying at Placida, and we're going to attempt to make the run down the beach to legendary Boca Grande Pass.
Zero-Bourne headed towards you, and it looks like Bill Zero-Bourne headed towards you.
Roger that. We just hit the intercoastal here. We're following the causeway across the bay.
They should catch up with you pretty good. They're going downwind now, both of them.
Yeah, once we hit the beach, we'll loiter around a little bit, give them a minute or two. Clear that water is today. Woo-wee. So the idea is we follow this little causeway across so you would have some emergency outs. Have to land on the road or right next to it, which wouldn't be fun, but it'd be better than going into water. So the place we're heading today, Boca Grande Pass, is a famous tarpon fishing area. Let's see, when I get up to these, close to these houses, I'm going to go ahead and hook to the right and make for that point over there so I don't have to fly directly over these homes. Okay, we'll go ahead and break right. Now we can. Holy cow, Carl McGee, I've never seen you that high before.
Yeah, that's probably about the highest I've ever been. I figured the splash of water was not as bad as concrete.
Yes, sir, I hear that. I'm gonna start dropping down. Oh, they're stuck on a sandbar down there, tearing up the prop. You want to wait for those guys, or you just want to head on down? I don't know how much fuel you got.
Let's head on down. I got enough for an hour and a half, 2 hours.
Roger that. Down the beach. I'm gonna get behind you so I can get some video. Is out of the east today, so it's blowing over top of these buildings. It's gonna make it turbulent down close to the beach, so unfortunately, but that's okay, we'll deal with it. Still quite a view. This is the Gulf of Mexico side of Florida, or the west coast. The Gulf of Mexico is relatively shallow compared to the Atlantic. The water's pretty clear today. The sun's not even up shining down yet, but you can see it's pretty darn clear. I have the lighthouse in sight. Some big money houses down there, boy. Sea turtles that nest on these beaches, and those guys down there, they watch over the nests, and they find them when they lay their eggs, and they mark them so people don't step in them. And they come out, and if the turtles don't eventually hatch, they dig them up and see if they can find out what happened. Unfortunately, there's really not any opportunity for landing today because the wind's out of the east and it's causing a lot of bad mechanical turbulence or rotor over top of the houses and condos. And you'd have to take off going from the water headed toward the shore, so that is obviously much less than ideal. that is the Boca Grande Lighthouse right there, ladies and gentlemen. A bit bumpy. Fingers are going to sleep in my right hand. Yeah, every year they have a huge tarpon tournament down here. It gets so full of boats here in the pass in Boca Grande that you could they say you could step from boat to boat to boat almost all the way across because of the tarpon. Roll in here in the spring and early summer and just get so thick. What is that? Stingrays down there? Yeah, stingrays. And Boca Grande is also famous for big sharks, big hammerheads. These guys will hook these, 150-pound tarpon, and they'll fight them and fight them and get them tired out, get them up to the boat, and then a giant hammerhead will come take it. Another school of stingrays down there. We often look for cobia with the stingrays. They tend to follow them.
I got it.
Down here they call these the old phosphate docks. There's a manatee right down there. Manatee down there, Carl.
Beautiful.
That's it, ladies and gentlemen. Boca Grande Pass. Those are the old phosphate docks over there. See, three more paramotors coming down the beach. We'll start to ease our way on back. And we'll cross paths with these guys. How about it, ground? You got a copy back there, Paul?
Thank you.
Yeah, you're breaking up pretty bad. We just hit the pass and turned around and started heading back up the beach. We're almost back to the lighthouse.
Okay, very good. Joe had to report. He got a little problem with the numbers that rise to that time. So he's leased that now. Everybody else is airborne. He should be back up in about 10 minutes.
Yeah, I see the other three paramotors headed southbound, and we're headed back in their direction.
Roger, copy loud and clear.
Thank you. look at these multi-million dollar mansions, beachfront mansions. I wonder what the poor people are doing. I tell you what they're doing, they're flying paramotors. I might not live in a beachfront mansion, but I'm a rich man because I get to do this every weekend. Look at the lawn on that place. Holy cow. Lawn is like a golf course. That there is an estate. All right, don't wave then. I guess this is all private beach. You have to own one of these homes or know somebody to get in here. Another manatee down there. See if I can get around here to take a look at it. I'm gonna be right into the sun now is a problem. Yeah, I lost him in the sun. Oh, there he is. It's a sea gorilla, manatee. There was a tarpon. Big tarpon. Go back and get another look at that. There's a big tarpon. Oh yeah, they're all laying out here off the beach this morning. I see. They look like logs. About 5 feet long. Big around as your thigh. If I can get close enough. Yeah, there he is right there. Silver King. Nice one. They lay out here off of these beaches and stack up like cordwood. They're no good to eat, but they're real fun to catch. What a trip, what a flight. Unbelievable. Tarpon right up in front of that boat. Yeah, they come up on these shallow bars and feed on the bait fish. And I guess they just like to lay there too. Okay, ground, we've made it back up the beach. We're getting ready to turn and cross the bay, headed in your direction. A little bit slower into the wind.
Okay, really good. Chase is getting ready to launch again. Kind of reset the chute here a little bit, the wind cut it. But that's all it's for.
Out, went across the bay, headed back. We're gonna use the same strategy we did on the way over. We're gonna follow the causeway that affords us an emergency out rather than going in the water. pumps are back in. We're going to go ahead and grab a little bit of altitude. Vigilant for air traffic. I haven't heard any traffic at Coral Creek, but I'm on the frequency on aviation radio. Yeah, roger that. We just made it across the bay and we're headed back across the mangrove flats.
Okay, he's headed right at you. Now he's landing again, he's got a problem.
I tend to lose my voice. I don't know, maybe I'm yelling on the radio and I don't realize it. I got the corona. What a beautiful flight. What a beautiful flight and a successful mission. We made it to Boca Grande Pass, flew by the lighthouse, flew over the old phosphate docks. Now we're headed in. We've been trying to plan this mission for a long time, but the weather always seems to switch on us. God damn it. All right, I guess I'm done vlogging. Now I can start my descent. I have safe landing zones in sight. I hope I don't got the coronas. Go down and get some drone footage of the other pilots coming back in. There's a sunken boat down there. I ain't found me a pirate shipwreck. Every time I try to talk like a pirate, I lose me voice. Let's dip down for some low-level action. You know what? I don't know if these dirty-ass sunglasses are doing me any good or not. They're probably doing me more harm than good. out of the OZ.
Looking good, Gorilla. Looking good. Dropped me in the pattern. That's where I'm going out to the taxi here.
Yeah, I didn't see or hear any aircraft over there either.
Yeah, I can see Carl out there low.
I'm proud of him. He was higher than I've ever seen him today.
I guess he had something about doing water landings, isn't it?
Yeah, I guess so.
We're the same as the rest before, almost maybe two. That's about it.
Roger that. I'm going to come in and get some drone footage of the other guys returning.
Carl, did you get a nosebleed being up that high?